an epidemic because, hands down, in my practice, this is by far the most common nutritional deficiency I see. And I've run more nutritional testing, arguably, than most doctors alive. We just run that much. It's that important to measure vitamins and minerals and nutrients in the blood. So, number one deficiency I see in chronically sick people is vitamin B12. And really, really chronic in those that are also gluten sensitive. So if you are gluten sensitive and you've never had your vitamin B12 measured, it'd be one of the highlights from today's show is to take that home and get your doc to run a vitamin B12 test for you. Now, not a serum test. We're going to talk about the types of tests here shortly, but you want to get that level checked if you know you're gluten sensitive, and let's talk about why. What causes vitamin B12 deficiency? Now, there are a number of different things that can cause B12 deficiency, but one of the biggest is poor diet. And when I say poor diet, I don't necessarily even mean that you're eating a diet that's bad for you so much as poor quantities of vitamin B12 in the diet. Where we really see people struggle to get adequate B12, aside from existing conditions like a gluten sensitivity or certain kinds of medications, and we'll talk about those too, is people that don't get enough animal protein. So enough animal protein. Now, many of you may be vegetarians, and many of you may, the vegetarian diet may be right for you. I'm not saying that you can't be vegetarian. If you're vegetarian, though, you should definitely be having your B12 levels checked on a regular basis, at least twice a year, to make sure that you're getting adequate quantities through supplementation. Because vitamin B12 is only really biochemically, the active form of vitamin B12 is only found in animal foods. So if you're not eating animal foods, again, you want to know that so that you can properly monitor your levels. Now, if you're eating plenty of meat, I see it too, where people are eating plenty of meat and they come back with vitamin B12 deficiencies, and there are other reasons why that can happen. So let's kind of dive into some of those. One of the reasons we get vitamin B12 deficiency is people that use medications that block stomach acid, so antacids. You require, the stomach requires, or the body requires acid to break the vitamin B12 away from the animal product, away from the egg or the liver or the beef or the fish or the chicken or the turkey or whatever it is that's your source. Remember, the sources for vitamin B12 are animal-based, so you've got to make sure that you're getting those. And if you're taking an antacid for heartburn or some other type of condition around heartburn, know that you're going to block your ability to absorb B12. So you may be eating plenty of B12 in your diet, but if you block the acid, then you block the ability to take B12 away from the meat and free it up so that your intrinsic factor in your stomach can bind it. I'll show you how that works here in just a minute. So antacids are a big one. Now, there are other classes of medications that we know can cause vitamin B12 deficiency. And another one is if you use metformin. Metformin is a drug that's used, so if you're a diabetic, if you've got high blood sugar, if you're a female and you've been told you had PCOS, it's a drug that helps sensitize you better to insulin, but it blocks B12. It also inhibits folate and CoQ10, so it's not even just B12 that it impacts, but that's the problem. Now, I'm going to give you a scenario here because many of you are diabetic. I mean, a vast majority of the U.S. population, 50, 60% is overweight or obese, and so we have this massive quantity of obesity and diabetes in our country, and many, many people are on metformin being vitamin B12 blocked. And so what's the problem, or what's the connection with that? Is that one of the side effects of diabetes is something called a neuropathy, a diabetic neuropathy. And so what happens is you take a drug to improve your insulin sensitivity to lower your blood sugar that blocks B12. Well, not only can diabetes cause a neuropathy, but a vitamin B12 deficiency over time can cause neuropathy. So what ends up happening is, and I've seen this happen to a number of people, develop a diet, what they thought was a diabetic neuropathy, not because they were diabetic and not because of the blood sugar issue was creating the nerve damage, but because the drug they were taking for so many years was blocking the B12, creating a vitamin B12 deficiency neuropathy. And a diabetic neuropathy and a B12 neuropathy are the same types of symptoms, numbness and tingling, and even in some acute cases, pain in the extremities. So the hands and the feet, we start to see that numbness and tingling set in. So a neuropathy is something you have to watch out for. Well, as it relates to B12, but antacids, metformin, there are other medications, antibiotics. Now, some of you may be thinking, well, Dr. Osborne, I don't take an antibiotic, I never have, or I try to avoid antibiotics at all costs. Many of the classes of antibiotics block vitamin B12, but you may not have taken an antibiotic. You may be eating meat that isn't grass-fed and organic, and understand that the vast majority of antibiotics that are used in our country are not used on humans. They're used on cattle. And so knowing that, if you're eating lots of meat, but the meat that you're containing has antibiotic in it, and that antibiotic is creating a vitamin B12 deficiency, this goes back to the example I mentioned earlier where, look, you may not be a vegan. You may be a meat-loving carnivore, right? And if you're eating and picking and choosing the wrong kinds of meat, then what's ended up happening is you're getting exposure to antibiotics that can inhibit your vitamin B12, and you still end up with a vitamin B12 deficiency. So again, these are some of the really super common causes. Aside from the diet not getting enough, we got blocking stomach acid, drugs like metformin, and antibiotics as being primary causes of vitamin B12 deficiency. Now, what I didn't mention yet is chemotherapeutic agents, and I'm going to just take a quick note here for you to mention chemo. Because many of you do chemo over cancer, or you know somebody who's doing chemo. And what I want you to understand, one of the functions of vitamin B12 is it helps your body replicate new DNA and RNA. Now, why is that important? You need B12 to replicate new DNA and RNA so that you can make new cells. And so one of the side effects of chemo is severe nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, especially the oral types of chemo that affect the gut directly. And so what happens is you're actually, one of the side effects of chemo is it inhibits vitamin B12 or can inhibit vitamin B12. And so what happens then is these people's guts go south really quick. Guts become leaky. And when your gut's leaky, you open yourself up to all kinds of problems, not just the cancer that you're trying to treat. Now, one of the things that can be done for those of you who are or know someone doing chemo is taking high doses, up to 10,000 micrograms of vitamin B12 to support the chemo, to support it from not making the gut stop working. Because again, when the gut quits working and you can't eat and the gut goes south, you can't get nourished, and then the cancer can take over and get even stronger. So vitamin B12, very, very important to help support those going through chemotherapeutic regimens to prevent the gut from becoming broken down aggressively. Remember, vitamin B12 is necessary for that rapid DNA turnover, and the gut cells have a 2-day life cycle. So every 2 days, those gut cells are being regenerated and they're brand new. It's one of the fastest tissues in the body as far as cell turnover is concerned, and you need lots of vitamin B12 to be able to make that happen. So low levels of B12, many people, they go gluten-free, they go on the AIP diet, or they go paleo, or they change their diet dramatically, diminish their food allergy exposure, and they don't heal that leaky gut, and a lot of times it's because of that vitamin B12 deficiency. They're still deficient in that vitamin B12. Hey, don't forget to check out the rest of the series right here. Make sure you hit subscribe below, and as always, thanks for tuning in.